worship. I'm supposed to be speaking at this mic. Okay, but we just thank God for all of you. And scripture says that the Lord is good. Everybody just say, the Lord is good.
The Lord is good.
Amen. How many know the rest of that? The Lord is good, and His what? His mercy. Everybody just touch somebody, just say, His mercy endureth. All right, just say it again, His mercy endureth. Amen. How long does His mercy endureth? All right, His mercy endureth forever. Amen. I thank God for each and every one of you. The scripture says the blessings of the Lord make it rich. How many believe that you're already legally rich? Amen. If you want to make that which is legally yours, yours in reality, then you have to act on the provisions that God has already what made for you being rich. Amen. We were away last week. I guess most of you picked it up by now if you weren't here. And we thank God for you that carried on and that y'all made it happen while I was gone. I really appreciate all of the participants and the ministers. I understand that Brother Williams had to substitute for the last minute for Brother Wayne. Man, so I want to just say we really appreciate all of you that made the work of the Lord possible on last week. I had some good experiences last week. We were in Pamela, Arkansas, and this is my former church. And all of the pastors, all of the ex-members out of town, various places, many of them returned to give respect to the founder, which was my brother. My brother is a pastor of two churches. I am left Little Rock. How many would like to go sometimes and just see another part of the world? How many haven't ever been out of Oklahoma? Okay. My brother has a multi-million-dollar funeral home. And I got to see that for the first time. He's been, y'all looking at me strange, and he's in the funeral business. You get him saved, get with the Holy Ghost, and pray for their healings, and if people don't make it, then he buried them. but it was really amazing how the impact that he has made in that city. Also, he has a church equally as large, I guess, in Little Rock, which is about 40 miles north of Pamela. It was a real blessing just to see how God worked. And Pamela is a small town, maybe 60 or 70,000, but about 50% of them are black. And everywhere you go, well, you see tons and tons and tons of black people. So that was really different than Tulsa, because Tulsa, the population is really small compared to Pamela. Amen. But we were tremendously blessed. We had a chance to exercise our ministry, and we just feel real rewarded for that opportunity to go to Arkansas and minister to the saints of God there. So we just appreciate the opportunity. And we'd like to take all of you all back one day, maybe next year. We had a pastor there from North Carolina. I had about 30 of his members all the way from Hendersonville, North Carolina. So he has pastors from all over coming in. So it was a real bless him. I just want to have a word of prayer. I just want to do some pastoral exhortation. I just feel that it's time for us to do some preparation for some things that God has really laid on our hearts. How many of you heard of fasting and prayer? How many don't like it? Amen. How many rather eat fast? All right. But there comes a time when saints gets kind of, you know, how can you describe it? We get so. And we're not motivated. And one good sign is when people begin to miss Bible study. That's a real big sign when people begin to fall out in prayer and just Sunday mornings, very little moving and stirring off of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The anointing needs to be working and operating mightily. As we get closer and closer to the coming of the Lord, we ought to experience a much greater anointing, a much greater commitment, a much greater consecration, and a much greater dedication to the Lord. If Jesus is to come soon, and we all believe he is, some have said the year 2012 is a year that something possibly could take place that will usher in the coming of the Lord. In other words, something that will take place that will lead to things that's predicted in the scriptures. So I just want to admonish you that if there ever were a time for us to come together and pray and seek God, it is now. It is now. So I just want to focus this message around getting back to your foundation and getting back to things that you know that God has called you to do, putting God first, seeking God, making some time in your schedule, making some sacrifices, and really getting back to the place where God initially visited us and really began to work through us. Amen. I just want you to just pray with me. If I had my choice this morning as to preach, I'm kind of like Jesus. Jesus did more praying than he did preaching. And he considered prayer more important than preaching or healing. Because without the prayer, he absolutely wouldn't have had any directions as to how to pursue those things that God really wanted them to do. Amen. So I just want everybody to stand with me just for a few moments. And I'm really beginning to feel the importance of really drawing people into the Spirit. Drawing people into the Spirit. Amen. Not just a counterfeit, superficial type of experience, but I'm thinking that there's going to be a pure and sincere devotion. Amen. God wants to show himself strong. God wants to be magnified. And I know that by us getting involved, how many work every day? I mean, we know that our jobs are serving us, is that right? How many don't feel like doing anything after you get through with your job? After your job gets through with you. Amen. So I'm trying to determine how many of y'all need vitamins. Lord, how many of y'all need to turn the TV on? I'm just trying to locate everybody. Because I'm believing God for a move of God. And we're getting ready to do some things in evangelism. And I know that in order for us to be fully equipped to impact people, we have to be beyond a whole lot of them. blockades and barriers that we are contending with. Amen. So let's just bow the heads this morning. I really feel that we need to give more, much more on Sunday mornings, but it seems like a lot of times we're drained, we're depleted, we're revitalized, we're innovated. And we just want to just bow our heads and just begin to pray. Father, help me to pray the way you want me to pray. Help me, Father, to get beyond my flesh, my lack of interest or desire in things that pertain to you. Lord, I need more. Help me to feel my sense of need. Help me to understand where I am in you. Lord, give me insight as to what I need to do in order to return to that place where I first found you. Oh God, hallelujah. Father, bring me to that point where I will be willing to deny myself and my flesh so that I can experience your best. People are dying, people are suffering, people are going into eternity. Hey, without Christ. Many, hallelujah, do not have any directions for their life. Oh, they're sinking deep in sin. Some are sinking to rise no more. Oh, but Lord, today, glory, we realize that only what we do for you will last. Only we're here, Lord, just for a period of time. You brought nothing into this world. We will take nothing away. All that we work so hard for will all be left behind. All that we put, things that we place before you, Lord, those things will not count when Jesus comes and when the fullness of time, hallelujah, hallelujah, has actually come to pass. Father, we thank you today for helping us to wake up and to be stirred and to get past our tiredness, all the discouragement and the frustrations and the anxieties and the things that we're dealing with, Lord. Lord, put joy in our hearts. Lord, restore the joy. Restore the joy. Lord, I believe everybody in here wants more joy. The joy that is full of glory, the peace of God that passes all understanding, the joy that's unspeakable and full of glory. Oh God, you're the joy of my salvation. Oh God, you can make the things that's not going right, you can bring them into line. Lord, you can restore even our first love. So precious seeds, so that we can come again with rejoicing, bringing out the seeds with us. Father, we thank you today that Satan's power is broken. We have no right, hallelujah, hallelujah, we have no reason to be discouraged and to be frustrated and to be under the dominion and the control of our circumstances. Father, we give you the praise, we give you the glory. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. In the name of Shanda. Lord, help my sister, help my brother. Oh, God, who don't have time. Hallelujah. Has been distracted from the, hallelujah, from seeking the faith, from reading the Bible, and from listening to you, and from praying in the Holy Ghost, from getting a miracle.
sins. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Father, we give you the praise. We give you the glory.
Yes.
We thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Oh,
thank
God, for the victory.
Thank you, Lord. Yes.
For this is the victory that overcomes. This is the victory that overcomes even our faith. We stand on the promises of God, and all of the promises in Him are yea and amen. Everybody just say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord, that I'm free.
Thank you, Lord,
that I'm free. And He, the Son, set free. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many can say, I'm free? How many can say, something is under my feet?
Building on a foundation that will last. and I wanted to read that scripture, and I wanted to give you some things that we want to get back to so that we can begin to focus on the right direction. There are things that definitely believers are held accountable for, and we don't want to veer off because of the cares of life. Everybody just said the cares of life. The Bible says that the cares of life, the deceitfulness of riches and the lust of other things, amen, can get you off track. And sometimes it's very difficult to get back on track. Amen. So I can sense because of schedules and the different cares and responsibilities and the way that we've been taken away from church. There was a time that all the saints could meet sometimes during the week at the same time. But now it's very difficult because of the schedules and the work schedules and the responsibilities and different things that we are involved with. It's very difficult. And sometimes it seems like we can't hardly connect with hardly nobody. I know if we continue this, that I know that somebody's not going to be ready when Jesus comes. I know that the problems and things will begin to multiply. And I know that some things are held together and don't get chaotic for you, even though maybe sometimes you are not on track, just because of people praying for you and the covering of the ministry overall. Amen. I was in a place recently, and it seems like a lot of the ministers or ministers' wives and people that I knew, all of them were broken down with, a lot of them had experienced a stroke. And of course, many of them had passed away that I knew. And these were people that I came up with from even much younger. So I think that by teaching the things that we have taught for many years, many of you have no idea as to how many things you have been spared of. You would be shocked of many, because of the wide range of things that we have taught, amen, that it has spared many of you of many terminal conditions. I believe, whether you believe it or not, I believe that even the anointing, when people really pray for real, when really people pray with all of their heart, when people really give everything, especially the way that we used to pray in this church, and what I want to get back to is praying with brokenness.
Yeah.
Pray until you really begin to experience a complete release. It's kind of difficult now, and we got to get back to that, because unless we can get back to praying with brokenness and letting God really have his way, then a lot of those tensions and frustrations and anxieties and things, that internal things, we're not going to be able to eliminate. We're not going to be able to get beyond those things, and we will become victimized by things that we could very easily get released from if we, amen, really understood the importance of praying with a broken spirit. And I want to kind of focus on that and to pray and try to get this reinstituted, because I think that everybody ought to have periodically, on a consistent basis, pray with brokenness. Brokenness is when you let go, let God, and God has his way. Most times you'll cry, you'll weep, you'll pray in the spirit, and you'll kind of get beyond your flesh. And it's a time of complete release and anointing. That time, the anointing of God really begins to work mightily in your body and in your mind and in your spirit. Amen. Correcting things, undoing what the devil has done, and bringing a peace, amen, that passes all understanding. Sister Hill gave me an article this morning, and she was telling about how many of the ministers all over the nation are just quitting the ministry in big groves. Droves, and a whole bunch of them. It's about 70-80% of those even going through seminary, they out of there in 5 years in terms of pastoral work because it's getting too frustrating. Because of the burdens and the loads and the depression and the challenges and the lack of commitment and response, the coldness, the deadness, the dryness, and many times people just stop showing up. So many of them having heart attacks and strokes and cancer, and they turn to pornography and everything else, and some drugs, and amen, just trying to get past what people are putting them through. Amen. So if I didn't pray, amen, I wouldn't even try. I wouldn't even try. Amen. Because it's too difficult. Try to carry people sometimes where they don't want to go. Sometimes nobody want to make a sacrifice. Nobody want to what? Pray. And we know that if we don't pray, that nothing's going to work for you. You can plant the word, but the word has to be what? Water. Is that right? A lot of times people can get a whole lot of head knowledge, but that still ain't going to what? That still won't work. Amen. You got to get it in your what? Heart. And most times it's going to require you what? Praying. Praying. How many can say pray the word?
Pray the word.
Amen. Not only pray it, but you've got to also, amen, you have to pray it with brokenness, pray it in the spirit, and just give it all over to God. You know, it's very rare now. And I'm just going to let the Holy Spirit lead me, because many times, you really don't know what you're saying sometimes when you're trying to, when you're talking to the same people, because many times they've already tuned you out. And sometimes it's just like putting what? Water on the what? The duck's back. Because they say, well, I didn't show up last week, and I ain't going to show up this week. Amen. I'm not going to get on y'all's case. Amen. But it's going to take a lot more. By me being a pastor, by me going to places and seeing how things are, the church where we attended last week, it was kind of full, because we had people coming from everywhere. Was this a town that got, you know, probably 25 or 30 or 40,000 black people? So it was a lot of black folks. So the church was almost full. It's probably about this big, because this was a special day. I don't know how things are normally, but they did have two or three churches coming together. The evening service, they had several churches coming together. Okay, but what I'm saying is that I called back Tuesday night, amen, because there was supposed to be regular service on Tuesday night, and the pastor told me, the assistant pastor, he said it was only two people there, three people. And this is just the way things are going now. Amen. Everybody, a lot more, show up on Sunday, but people just forgot about things that that basic and foundational that they have to do in order to get their foundation strong. Jesus said that he that hear these sayings of mine and don't do them, he's like a person that builds his foundation on a what? On sand. All right, and the person that hears these things and what? Do them, practice them. Amen. It's like building on a what? On a rock. How many rather be on a rock? All right. Rock means that you're going to have to do some things, and you're going to have to change your course and get on the rock, because quite a few of us graduates, this is the reason why you have pastors. Amen. That's the reason why you have pastors. You ought to be glad to have a good pastor. Amen. Everybody is not going to tell you and practice and lead you into prayer. So Some churches that will never exhort you to pray. You'd be surprised. And of course, if people are not exhorted to pray, they're not going to what? They're not going to pray. Some people are never exhorted to, amen, to fast and pray. There's got to be a time that you have to what, exert a lot of what? Self-restraint. You're going to have to what? You're going to have to deny your flesh in order for the bad to be what? Released from you, your spirit. I mean, God wants to get the bad out.
That's right.
And he wants to get the what? Good in.
Yes.
And many times that's going to require you what? In that time that you're going to have to what? Humble yourself. And you're going to have to what? Deny your flesh and stop eating. So that's my assignment. Of course, I don't want it. But the Lord told me that I just got to get you back to fasting and prayer. Otherwise, the cares of life and whatever you were doing is just going to take over everything. And prayer is just going to get so foreign and so awkward. When Brother Dean tried to lead you in prayer, you're just going to stare and look. And see, that's the reason why praise and worship leaders don't. I don't know how many of them, praise God, are going through the same burnout like pastors are. Amen. So it's going to take a lot more for us to get ourselves in a position where, amen, we can get back to the sincere devotion and the sincere walk that we had with the Lord, in which your life will mean something and your life will carry some kind of power or impact. So you want your life to be counted.
Yes.
Is that right?
Amen.
You just don't want to be a statistic. You don't want to just come to church and go through the motion, go through the act, and when somebody needs to be saved, what? You don't have nothing to offer that much. Every one of y'all, I know y'all love me, don't you?
Yes.
Every single one of y'all ought to be able to get anybody that you approach saved. Amen. If you're full of the Holy Ghost, you don't have to know a whole lot of word. If you fast and pray and stay consecrated, you don't have to what? You don't have to know much. Just be anointed.
Amen.
Just have a charge, electrical charge on the inside. That's called the anointing. And that anointing, the Bible says, he that goeth forth weepeth.
Yes.
Bearing precious seeds. He that goeth forth what? Weepeth.
Yes.
And you can't find nobody that serious about God hardly no more. That's broken. That really have the same in God's interests at heart. Amen. See, I didn't want to preach a formal. I have a whole lot of notes written down. Boy, I worked on this one. And the Lord just said, just get up and talk. Kind of risking. Kind of scary, huh? But God said, I just want you to talk to their hearts. If you're reading a whole lot of stuff to them, he said, they ain't going to pay you no attention. They ain't going to pay you too much even if you're talking to their hearts. Glory, hallelujah. But he that goeth forth weepeth. That's what God is looking for. He's looking for a heart that's broken. Looking for a heart that really sense a need. Really, Lord, I don't have what it takes. By now I should have several hundred people to my credit, as long as I've been saved. But Lord, I want you to position me where my life can have some impact on people around me that's perishing. How many know that we've been talking for the last several weeks about the Lord's compassion? And everything I mentioned about the Lord, that's the thing that the Lord wants us to have. Amen. He wants us to be moved with what? Compassion. How many can say amen?
Amen.
And the scripture says, if we go forth weeping and bearing precious seed. All right. Now, having God's interest at heart is the most important thing in your life. Having God's interest at heart. If you don't have God's interest at heart, then that means what you and God are not what? You're not what? On one accord. If you're not God, if you and God are not on the same course, going the same way, and have the same interest and the same desires, then that means that your faith cannot work. Results are impossible. So who wants to waste all of your Christian life coming to church, making sacrifices, and doing all of this, and it's not going to count for much? Because God is going to hold us accountable for people around us that we could have reached. Their blood is going to be on our what? Hand. If we don't perk up. Amen. So I said, well, I told them. You know, sometimes we try to do all that we can in the flesh. How many can say amen? But when you do it in the flesh, and not in the power of the Holy Spirit, then you do not get any credit for it in judgment. The judgment seat of Christ, you do not get credit for that, provided if you do make it. See, the only works that will count, the works of gold, silver, precious seeds, precious stones, rather, these works are works that are done under the power, in the power of what? The Holy Ghost. You know, y'all, we heard that only what we do for Christ will last. We all heard that, right? Only what we do for Christ will what? Will last. So whatever you do, make sure you do it in the power of the Holy Spirit. So that means that you're going to have to what? Put some prayer power in what you're doing. And that's the reason why I have given up trying to make anything happen on my own, because I know it's impossible. Amen. And that's the reason why I have changed my prayer, I've changed my commitment to God, I've changed my giving, I've changed everything, because I know that if I do things in the strength of my own ability and the way I want to do it, the way I feel like it should be done, I'm going to be doing it in the power of my own ability. And it will not count for much, if anything. Amen. I'm learning, and this is the reason why I want to get you back to fasting and prayer. Because we got to get to the point where we are completely sold out and completely dependent upon the Holy Spirit doing everything that God wants done through us. It can't be no James Hill. And the only way I can get James Hill out of the way, I have to submit sometimes to some discipline. Amen. Let a whole lot of some teeth go. A whole lot of mornings. A whole lot of days. Just what? Pass the plate up. Pass the food up. Amen. Scripture says he that seeketh to save his life is going to what? Lose it. But he that loses his life for my sake and the gospel's sake shall what? Find it. Amen. So God wants to get at the core of your life. That's all I can say. He wants to get at the core of your life, and he wants you pouring out the best you have. And he's tired of all of this mechanical stuff. Sometimes we don't hardly do anything when we come to Holy Jewish. Oh yeah, y'all gonna have to pray. Y'all rub me down on the spot. Amen. This gotta be real. This gotta be real. It's gotta come from your heart. And when it comes from your heart, it's gonna what? Break you, and it's going to cause brokenness, and that's when the real you is going to what? Begin to be released from your spirit. The scripture says, he that goeth forth weepeth and beareth precious seeds shall doubtless come again with what? Rejoicing.
Yes, amen.
Bringing his what? Sheep.
That's right.
Amen. I'm going to do everything I can beginning this week to encourage you, amen, and to help you. I don't care what type of skill.